Recently, the SETI, or Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, released an application called SETI at Home, which allows any regular computer to help the SETI researchers find alien intelligence. This idea is brilliant since it saves an enormous amount of money by distributing processing power throughout computers all around the globe instead of buying super expensive supercomputers. So anyone could go to their website and download this application to help the SETI researchers crunch data to find extraterrestrials. This way, the entire internet can be turned into a giant supercomputer. But what if we needed a processing capacity that far exceeded all the computers on Earth used in conjunction? Well, for such vast computational power, we may have to look beyond our planetary resources directly to the stars. This is where the idea of the Matrioshka brain proposed by Robert J. Bradbury comes in. In his 1960 paper, Search for Artificial Stellar Sources of Infrared Radiation, physicist and mathematician Freeman Dyson proposed the idea of a megastructure. Now commonly known as a Dyson Sphere, it was conceived to spot other advanced civilizations in our universe, particularly Kardashev Type 2 civilizations that are capable of controlling all of the available energy in their stellar system. Dyson believed that a Type 2 civilization should be able to build this hypothetical megastructure around its star, which would completely encircle it and harness all its energy. There have been many variations of the Dyson sphere since its conception. The simplest of these megastructures would be a Dyson ring. It would be made up of a ring of solar-powered collectors in orbit around its star with a radius of 100 million miles. But having just one ring wouldn't be enough. To harness all of the power of its star, a Type 2 civilization would use many Dyson rings in orbit around its star, giving rise to a Dyson swarm. There are other variations of this, like a Dyson bubble, which would use satellites instead of solar-powered collectors suspended by the use of enormous light sails, using radiation pressure to counteract the pull of gravity from the star, or Dyson shell, which would be a uniform solid shell of matter around the star intercepting 100% of the star's energy output. It is believed that a Type 2 civilization would not just build these megastructures, but also live in them and completely control what goes on inside of them, according to Freeman Dyson. But Robert Bradbury extended this idea in his anthology, Year Million, Science at the Far Edge of Knowledge. He proposed that far in the future, we would have a technology to create a set of nested shells around a star, each of which will essentially be a Dyson sphere. Now, because this megastructure is similar to the nested Russian Matryoshka dolls, Bradbury called his concept a Matryoshka brain. In theory, this solar system-sized machine would be the most powerful computer in the universe, capable of harnessing all the useful energy from a star while rendering it essentially invisible at visible wavelength. The Matryoshka brain would be able to carry out such vast amounts of calculations in just a single second that even if all the 7 billion plus brains were put together, they still wouldn't be any match for it. Now, to work as a supergiant computer or the highest capacity thought machine, a Matryoshka brain would draw its power directly from the star and spread it throughout the network of encompassing shells. The first shell would acquire as much energy as it could from the star and use it for computational processes. Now, these processes will generate and radiate heat energy, which can in principle be captured to perform more computation. This would be done by a second shell that surrounds the first shell. The second shell is just like the first shell, but it gets its energy from the heat waste of the first shell instead of directly from the star. This process would repeat until all the radiated heat energy was consumed. For this reason, the inner shells could run at nearly the same temperature as the star itself, while the outer ones would be close to the temperature of interstellar space. So naturally, a Matryoshka brain with more nested Dyson spheres would be more efficient since it would waste less heat energy. But that's not all. The shells or spheres of the Matryoshka brain would be composed of a hypothetical material nearing the theoretical limit of computational power called computronium. Computronium can be defined as programmable matter which supports computation, especially in artificial substances suitable for high-efficiency computation. So in essence, every particle of computronium would behave like a microcomputer capable of interacting and sharing information with other particles. Apart from this, we may also need an enormous amount of silicon, which we can mine from the planet Venus as raw material. Now, if we could construct such a massive structure in our solar system, its shells or spheres would expand from the orbit of Mercury beyond the orbit of Neptune, according to Bradbury. However, a project of this caliber is far beyond what our civilization can currently accomplish. But there have been several proposals on how we could potentially build a Matrioshka brain right here in our solar system. One of the methods for implementing a Matrioshka brain would be through self-replicating machines mentioned by Bradbury, which are now being created. Billionaire entrepreneur Peter Diamandis recently created a company called Planetary Resources with the goal of mining asteroids to make the infrastructure for building a Dyson Sphere. Moreover, another company with the name Made in Space is researching and working on designing 3D printing technology that would work in space with the ultimate motive of setting up factories that could replicate themselves in outer space. Bradbury predicted, based on our current trends, that humans would be able to build a megastructure like the Matrioshka brain roughly by 2250. Now that would be pretty cool, but what can we accomplish with a super powerful computer like the Matrioshka brain on our side? Well, with the computational power of a Matrioshka brain, we could do just about anything, from simulating entire alternate universes to running perfect simulations of human minds into virtual reality spaces supported by the Matrioshka brain. We may even upload our own minds into these virtual spaces and become a completely different immortal species. But how can we even tell that we do not already live in a simulated reality that engages all of our senses? Well, some entrepreneurs and scientists, including Elon Musk, believe that we may already be living inside a Matrioshka brain. One of the reasons for this belief is that it answers one of the biggest paradoxes of all time, the Fermi paradox. It proposes that perhaps we or some other species have already advanced to become a Kardashev Type 2 civilization and have uploaded their consciousness and memories into a Matrioshka brain. This is why we do not encounter any other alien life forms in our universe, since no simulation of them exists within our simulated reality. So we may be living in a simulated reality, as there is no way to tell the difference between a simulated reality and an actual reality if we were to be living in a Matrioshka brain simulation. And that brings us to the end of this video. Do leave a like, share, and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Also, let us know your thoughts and what you like to see next in the comments down below. Until then, we'll see you in the next one.